One of the biggest mistakes people make when it comes to high cholesterol levels is that they don't know how to control it and how much cholesterol per day they eat from different foods. Well, the official advice from the American Heart Association, USDA, and other groups is to limit your cholesterol intake per day to less than 200 milligrams. But how do you know how many milligrams of cholesterol per day are you eating? Let's see some food examples that contain the daily cholesterol intake of 200 milligrams. Fried chicken, 3 to 4 pieces or 200 grams, croissants, 4 rolls, cheddar cheese, 8 slices, ice cream, 9 small scoops, egg yolk, 1 yolks, lamb, 7 ounces or 200 grams, bacon, 15 pieces, steak, 7 ounces of steak or 200 grams, and at last salami with 10 slices. The organizations which provide information about the daily recommended cholesterol intake say that you should not consume more than 200 milligrams, but that's not the only number you should strive for. While checking cholesterol numbers, also take a look at the trans and saturated fats, which have a much bigger impact on raising cholesterol level. The American Heart Association recommends limiting the saturated fats to only 5 or 6% of your total daily calories. Problems arise when you eat too many saturated and trans fats. These cause your liver to produce too much LDL, bad cholesterol, which winds up in artery-clogging deposits. So, for a 2000 calorie diet per day, that would be about 100 to 120 calories or around 11 to 13 grams. Let's have a look over saturated fats in different foods. As you can see in this dairy products table, if you drink 1 cup of whole milk and eat 3 ounces of cheddar cheese, you already reach the saturated fat limit for a day. As you can see in this meat and protein table, you can reach the maximum daily limit of saturated fats by just eating a pork chop of 4 ounces, or you can even go way over this limit by eating the same quantity of beef short ribs. Now, how to lower your cholesterol daily intake as well as saturated fats? Simple, you should avoid saturated fats found in bacon, cured meats like salami, cheese, butter, coconut oil and palm oil, sausages, cakes, biscuits, coconut milk and coconut cream, milkshakes, fatty cuts of meat, pastries such as pies, sausage rolls and croissants, cream, crème fraîche and sour cream, ice cream, chocolate and chocolate spreads. Trans fats may be even more dangerous because they raise the LDL or bad cholesterol levels and lower HDL, the good cholesterol, at the same time. Most trans fats are formed through an industrial process that adds hydrogen to vegetable oil. You should decrease your daily trans fats intake in order to lower LDL cholesterol level. The following foods should be avoided: frozen pizza, refrigerated dough such as biscuits and rolls, baked goods such as cakes, cookies and pies, non-dairy coffee creamer, stick margarine, shortening, microwave popcorn, fried foods including french fries, donuts and fried chicken. In conclusion, it's good to read the labels on all products you consume and see how many saturated fats they actually contain. Don't worry about eating enough cholesterol every day. Your body produces enough whether you consume it from food or not. Eat more healthy, unsaturated fats. Try replacing butter with extra virgin olive oil in cooking, buy lean cuts of meat, and snack on nuts and seeds instead of french fries or processed snack foods. Alright, if you're getting value in this video, hit the like button. Thanks! Have you got any more questions related to cholesterol? Let me know that in the comment section down below. If you want to maintain an optimal cholesterol level and you're wondering how to do it, make sure to check out the Mediterranean diet video. Thank you very much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in a future video.